Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to another astrology report. I hope you're all doing good. This report is going to be for March 19 through March 25 of 2024. I had to take off last week for some personal business, but I am back to talk about a very pivotal time of the year that we're entering into, which is eclipse season. So we do have this big main event, the Libra Lunar Eclipse, by next Monday, March 25. I'm going to go through the astrology for the whole week ahead leading up to that event, look at all the major aspects, go through the charts day by day as I usually do, and talk about the overall astrology. But that is going to be one of the big things that we're headed for. Actually, today is very important as well, though. We have the Sun ingressing Aries by tonight for the astrological new year, the equinox. Change of focus, change of season, and a very big turning point for the rest of the year ahead. We also have Mercury that has entered its retrograde shadow at this point, which means Mercury is going to go retrograde in Aries in April, the beginning of April, and retrograde all the way back to this point, roughly about 16 degrees of Aries at the end of April, the last week of April, to station direct. So what is coming in at this point this week, since yesterday pretty much, is going to be a part of the Mercury retrograde, what we're thinking about, what area of your birth chart is 16 degrees of Aries, you know, all the way through the rest of Aries. That whole section of your chart is what this Mercury retrograde is all about, a process unfolding that's going to take time, basically until Mercury leaves Aries by May 15 and ingresses Taurus. So we are entering a very important time. Plus, that's exactly where the North Node of Destiny is right now, pointing towards where Mercury is going to retrograde back to. So pay attention to what's on your mind, any information, communications, thoughts, ideas, any new developments that will be unfolding from this point on. It has destiny connected to it and the future. So it could be very important. Now, if you have personal planets around 16 degrees of Aries, it's even more significant for you, or within a few degrees of 16. So pay attention to what's going on in that regard. We also have Mercury conjunct Chiron, a part of this retrograde process as well. And remember, the solar eclipse in Aries at 19 degrees will be conjunct Chiron as well. So Chiron is a big part of this. I'll talk about the meaning of Mercury Chiron when I go through the charts on the daily. We also have the Sun in Aries sextile Pluto by March 21st. That's usually a positive aspect. And then we have Venus conjunct Saturn. That's going to be a big main vibe of the week ahead. Venus and Pisces conjunct Saturn. Serious relationship dynamics are playing out. Plus, that Libra lunar eclipse has a lot to say about relationship changes and a turning point. We also have Mars changing signs. Mars will ingress Pisces by March 22nd. So a change to what motivates us, a change to our drive and instincts. And that's going to be a big factor in the eclipses as well, because the solar eclipse in Aries will be ruled by Mars in Pisces. So that Pisces area of your life in your birth chart is also in focus for some major developments connected to these perhaps life-changing eclipses, especially if you have planets around the degrees of these eclipses or in the middle of Pisces. And then we have Jupiter in conjunct to the South Node. That's by March 23. We're going to have Venus in conjunct to the South Node, but also Venus will then make a sextile aspect to Jupiter by March 24. So Venus is connecting to both Saturn and Jupiter this week. That's very significant. Also considering Venus rules the Libra lunar eclipse. And then we have that main event, like I said, by next Monday, March 25, lunar eclipse slash full moon in Libra with the South Node. So I'll be talking about that event as I get to next Monday on the daily chart. We're going to have the moon waxing through the sign of Leo, waxing all through Virgo, and then becoming full in Libra by next week. All right, folks, so that's the major aspects. And if you want to find out when all these come exact throughout the week, check the description. I have timestamps there if you want to follow along. And also there's a link if you want to buy a personalized report from me, get on my work list. We can take a look at your year ahead for the next 12 months. Also take a look at your progressions, what's going on for you in a bigger context of life too. And that can be very insightful. If you like this video, click the like button. If you don't like what I do here, click the down arrow. But it does help with getting this video out to more people, unfortunately. But let's go through the daily chart here and talk about all these aspects. So looking at the chart overall, we have a lot of Pisces still. You know, this is the last day of Pisces until we get to that equinox tonight. So it is a change of season. We still have Venus, Saturn, Neptune in Pisces though, and that's still going to be a big influence of what's behind the scenes, energetic sensitivity. I think that there's been a lack of motivation in a lot of ways with the Sun and Neptune this last week, and can bring up illness, can bring up just draining of energy, but it also enhances dreams, fantasies, and just overall intuitiveness and sensitivity from behind the scenes. But with the Sun changing signs tonight, it is a really big change. And that is going to be, like I said, at 8:06 tonight, we enter the equinox. Before we get there, though, for the rest of Tuesday, the moon has just ingressed Leo for a change of mood and circumstances for the next 2.5 days. And it's quite significant because the moon in Leo is ruled by the sun. That's also going to be changing signs. The moon and sun are in harmony, both from Cancer to Pisces, from Leo to Aries. But the moon here does have to oppose Pluto for the rest of Tuesday before we get to the equinox. And that can add a little bit of emotional intensity, some power struggles, just the general mood and circumstances could be a little bit edgy, and the undercurrents could be a little bit intense as well. Transformation for the circumstances, the overall mood and vibe for the day could be coming, could start to change and be noticeable for the rest of Tuesday. So let me just go through these charts day by day, starting with Tuesday here. We have that main event with both a change in focus and mood and circumstances. And I think it's going to be really significant for the equinox, the astrological new year, a change of focus. So now your Aries area of life is where the sun is and where the eclipses are going to be as well. Let me move this forward here. So once we get past that Pluto opposition, I think things can start to change for the better a little bit here. With the sun in Aries, it's very strong. The sun is exalted in Aries, so it's a very powerful focus. It has a lot of say about putting the focus on the individuality, the self, freedom, and independence. But also Aries is about bravery and courage and pioneering things, initiating things. So at first, I think it's just the very beginning of this change of focus for people. Wherever you have Aries in your birth chart, that's where the focus is. And we're also at this equal point of the year between light and dark, you know, with the equinox. And the astrological new year, it's kind of a beginning point for something new to start coming in. A new focus, like I said, a new purpose for the rest of the year. And once we get to that solar eclipse, that's really going to be highlighting this long-term change of purpose and focus for a lot of people. It really depends how much you have of Aries in your birth chart. If you have a lot of Aries and Libra in your birth chart with planets there, you know, these eclipses are really going to affect you the most. But if you have nothing in Aries, you still have an area of your life that's all about Aries, and that's where the focus is. So check your birth chart. What is Aries for you? Again, it's usually about initiating something, having bravery and courage to take action. It's about the self in a lot of ways. It's where you like to do things independently in your life. And there's a bigger process unfolding to figure something out about that with the Mercury in shadow going retrograde in this area. So this is the new focus for the next month now with the Sun in Aries. Now this Sun in Aries is ruled by Mars. So it really puts more emphasis over here on Mars at the last degrees of Aquarius. But that vibe is going to change later on in the week when Mars ingresses Pisces. So from now, for the next 4 days or so, it's really focused on the Aquarius, hopes, wishes, and dreams. What do you need to start? You know, it's not necessarily like you need to start it right this moment, instantly. It's more like, you know, a part of this bigger process that's going to start unfolding, to be taking action in new ways, to start something in your life that will have a long-term effect for the future. And it comes back to this Aquarius, hopes, wishes, and dreams for the future. It comes back to group, community, friends, social situations. In a world mundane context, it puts a lot of emphasis on military situations and also politics. You know, changes within politics are going to start showing, new situations, new developments coming out, and then also perhaps a change in military activity in different places around the world now. That's much more about taking the initiative and conquering and, you know, pioneering, going out and doing new levels of activity. But in a personal chart, it all depends on where you have this Aries. And it also just puts more emphasis on the self. But that's a part of these overall eclipses, is to find a better balance in life between the self and other people. And I'll talk about that Libra eclipse when we get there. That's also a big part of that, finding a rebalancing between the self and other in your life, relationships, but yet still maintain your individuality, how to be yourself, how to not get lost within a relationship and lose your sense of self. You know, there's a development for the self here and the individuality and things that you want to get for yourself. And this is also a time of year to go after things, to not be passive, to take the initiative for change in your life that this is talking about. So, pretty big turning point for tonight with that equinox. And from this point on, more and more light day after day and less darkness. So that's the last aspect of the day. So it really turns into a fiery kind of focus and mood for the next few days with the moon in Leo and the sun in Aries starting tonight. So it's much more outward. It's passionate. It's expressive. With the moon in Leo here for the next 2.5 days, especially waxing forward, it's about self-expression, having fun, recreation, being more passionate and a little more dramatic with situations. The mood is a little more dramatic and passionate and fiery and active, especially with Mars still in Aquarius. So that's for Tuesday, March 19. Until we get to Wednesday, March 20th. Moon is still in the beginning stages of Leo, so that overall mood is still in play with self-expression, wanting to be a little more dramatic and outgoing, social, passionate, creative, active. This all continues for the rest of the week here. But the moon does make an inconjunction to Venus for the first aspect on Wednesday. So the mood is at odds with Venus over here. Venus approaching Saturn is a much more mature Venus right now, much more of a serious Venus. So Venus is where the pleasure is. Venus is where the relationship dynamics are at. And Venus's overall value and worth and attraction. It's in a more serious vibe right here next to Saturn building up behind the scenes. So this moon in Leo on Wednesday, that's more outgoing and passionate and dramatic and active, is clashing with this preference of behind the scenes sensitivity, serious relationship activity, the serious developments that are more laid back and not as active and passionate and dramatic. So the mood, which is our needs, emotional needs, and what we're emotionally hungry for, is not feeling quite satisfied or pleasured as much. You know, and then relationships could start to go through some tricky dynamics this week overall, you know, with being eclipse season here, with Venus next to Saturn, relationships are going to have to go through some changes. And they're a little bit heavy, they're a little bit serious, and the mood is just not down for that. The mood wants pleasure, it wants a good time, it wants to be social and outward with situations. So it's just a little more challenging typically, and this isn't a long-term vibe, it's just a temporary aspect on Wednesday where the moon is clashing with Venus. So the mood is clashing with the desires and the preferences, which is usually an indication of not being fulfilled as much, especially in relationship, financial dynamics, and overall pleasures of different kinds. So it's much more of an independent vibe, doing things for the self, being more independent, doing what you want, fiery and active, but don't expect, you know, pleasure, relationships, and money to be the source of your fulfillment necessarily, basically. And then we also have Mercury conjunct Chiron. So that can be communications and thoughts about wounds or healing. There can be a lot of conversations or news about something around healing, you know, medical health situations on the news, or it could also talk about wounds and wounded, injured people and things like that. But it's also our own mind and thoughts going through this connection to Chiron, the wounded healer in the sign of Aries, our independence, our confidence about ourself, being brave and courageous to start new things, you know, without it just landing in our lap and having other people do it for us, taking the initiative. There's a need for confidence here. Luckily, the sun is very confident in the sign of Aries. And the moon here in Leo is also very confident. But we have to work on something about healing the self, a part of this whole eclipse season. And for that matter, the whole year, you know, with this north node and the eclipses with Chiron, what about yourself do you need to heal? You know, it's like taking the appropriate action, being brave and courageous and making things happen for yourself can go a long way in making you feel better about yourself. Or do you feel weak? Do you feel like a victim? Do you feel like you have to have other people do something for you? Those are all indications of being wounded in the sign of Aries, of the self. So taking the initiative, stepping up to the plate, being brave and courageous can go a long way in self-healing with this dynamic. But regardless, the mind is also a little bit going through some, you know, sensitivity perhaps as we go through midweek here. And remember, this is where Mercury is going to come back to at the end of April and station direct. So by the time we go through all of April, we should be ready for something different, looking at things differently, having a different perception on the self and our individuality. All right, so there's that. And then we do have Moon in conjunct to Saturn tomorrow as well, right before the Moon squares Jupiter. So, I mean, the first part of the day, it's full of inconjunctions and a Chiron conjunction with Mercury. It's not the best, you know, vibes here. These green lines are the inconjunction, also known as the quincunx. That's where these two signs don't even mix at all. They don't even see each other. They're not on the same page. That can lead to irritation. It leads to having to make adjustments based on other things that are going on in the day, you know, versus what we want, where our mood is. So things are just kind of clashing, a little bit of irritation, frustration, adjustments to different things of the day in the first part of the day. And so the moon is like totally at odds with Venus and Saturn over here, which is the circumstances of the day. So we have to adjust to serious things as well, serious responsibilities, commitments, duties, obligations, you know, more of our mature side, our responsible side versus play, having a good time, doing what we want, being outward, active. You know, we may have some limitations to the day for what we want and how we're going to get it. And then the moon, though, it does square Jupiter for the later on in the afternoon, or rather, this is Wednesday night with moon square Jupiter. So big needs, big appetite for things, circumstances, the mood, a little bit over-amplified, over-inflated. That can be generous, spending too much, being overly generous, trying to be fulfilled by something. Like I said, a big emotional appetite for something, big needs, but it's hard to get fulfilled by it because, again, Venus and Saturn are totally at odds with what the circumstances and the mood are hungry for. So it could be a little bit over dramatic with situations, overdoing things. Just kind of tone it down a little bit for Wednesday night. But generally, the whole background vibes for the world are overly amplified in dramatic ways. Could be connected to financial situations in some way, though, as well. But also with pleasure and pleasurable needs of some kind. And then, for the last aspect, The moon is connecting to the nodes of fate as well in a trine and sextile. So circumstances are in alignment with the destiny. The mood is somehow connected to the future, what we want, our individuality, connected to relationship activity as well, potentially here in this more Leo outward, social, creative, fun type of mood that's going on here. So that's Wednesday, March 20th. And then we go forward to Thursday, March 21. And things look a little bit easier here other than Venus, Saturn, but we do have the moon still in Leo, so that mood continues from Tuesday night, where the moon in Leo is about, again, being more outward, creative, fun, passionate, expressive. It's still in this area that wants to have a good time, but I just think there's more serious things going on that kind of limit us from how much fun we can actually have for the next couple of days. But the moon is also in great alignment with Chiron and Mercury first thing on Thursday morning. So the mood is in good alignment with the mind, the thoughts, the communication, the information. So that's usually, you know, maybe a good time for errands, getting out and about. It's, again, fire. It's more active and outward and passionate and communicative. Mercury's in a very quick spot here, sharp and quick. And the moon is ruled by this sun in Aries as well, which the sun is connecting to Pluto on Thursday in a sextile. So intense focus, intense communication, passionate and expressive, and overall the focus could start to go through some sort of a transformation on Thursday into new vibes here. But overall, it's pretty like when people are communicating, because keep in mind, Leo, the moon in Leo is ruled by the sun, and it's in alignment good with Mercury of communication. So this can be very intense communication, passionate communication, persuasive communication. There's also, this is the world point. Keep in mind, the equinox for the next couple of days, the sun is on the world point. So there's a lot of world context connected to what's going to be unfolding for the rest of this week. So this is connecting new situations with politics, the power and the structure of politics, community organizations, science, government. But there's also this need to be very powerfully communicative and outward and social. Keep in mind, Mars is coming to the last degree of Aquarius, ruling all of this Aries. So it puts more emphasis on it. It's more intense. It's more critical. It's more, has a sense of urgency to be more outward and social with the moon in Leo, opposite Aquarius, and then all this Aries. So there's still a little bit of a vibe that's pulling us behind the scenes still with situations with Venus, Saturn. But overall, there's a bigger vibe that's pulling people outward to be more active, passionate, expressive, and social through the week ahead. But the big conjunction is definitely this Venus-Saturn on Thursday afternoon here. Let's see when that's exact. Yeah, that's going to be Thursday night mostly. I mean, it's kind of already there now and building up for the rest of the week. But Venus-Saturn is definitely intense. Not so much intense, but more serious relationships. There's serious relationship vibes. There could be a sense of some limitations, some restrictions within a relationship. It's not overly passionate, especially when the moon leaves Leo, ingresses Virgo with the change of mood, and then the moon will eventually oppose Venus and Saturn later on. I'll get to that. But it's not as, there is going to be some issues with relationships. Issues that are building up to that lunar eclipse, which is a turning point for relationships. It doesn't have to be bad. Venus-Saturn could also be talking about commitments for the long-term future, especially the fact that Mercury is in its retrograde shadow, where it's going to be going back and forth in this area. Whatever's coming up, whatever's being communicated, your thoughts, your ideas, you know, if there's any connection to relationship, it could be about commitments, serious relationships that are ready to change. You know, but it could go either way. It could be about a restriction and a limitation to the love, the pleasure, the relationship vibes, or it could be more serious about the future as well. Jupiter here, it rules this conjunction of Venus-Saturn, and Jupiter is moving past its retrograde shadow into new territory that wants to start moving something forward. It's also connecting Jupiter to the south node of relationships. And so there's something about relationships here that's quite serious. I think it has a positive connection overall, because once Venus gets past this serious dynamic, it makes a sextile to Jupiter, which is a positive connection moving into new territory for the future, something more abundant and positive connected to Venus. But this is also about money and resources of what's going on Thursday. Now, this is later. This is after the markets are closed, the New York markets. So it could be affecting markets building up to this point by Thursday, but I would be cautious. I'd be conservative overall with your spending and buying this week, especially by midweek into Thursday. And overall, even if you're not connected to the markets or buying or selling, you just want to generally be more conservative. Go with the flow and don't fight against what the astrology is talking about. Relationships, money, and resources are in a more conservative spot right now. So it's not about overdoing it. Now, sometimes it can be about big ticket items, but it's like a commitment that you would have to make for a big ticket item if you are purchasing something in that regard. There's a potential of that considering Venus crossing Saturn and then making a sextile to Jupiter in the financial area of the chart. So this could be like Venus approaching Saturn by Thursday. Do you have to get a loan? Do you have to talk to the man, you know, someone of authority that you're applying for, you know, that you're trying to get support from Saturn? And then it goes through when Venus connects to Jupiter, you know, for the rest of the week. So if you have to buy something major, you make sure it's something that you're willing to make a long-term commitment to in some way, and make sure it's important. And then you'd be in the flow of buying something in a serious way for the future. But overall, you should still be a little conservative with everything for this week. And then just know relationships are a little more serious behind the scenes. You know, preferences are in a very, generally, preferences are in a mature spot here. They want something more refined. You know, love, how you do love, how you engage in relationship activity. It's not an immature position here. It's more refined and more mature. So, yeah, keep that in mind when you're dealing with relationship. But I would still say there's a big chance of some limitation within the love, how much love you could receive, how much love is going out, coming in, things like that, how affectionate people are. Sometimes with Venus Saturn, it's not as affectionate. But I still see positivity connected to this in a financial way somehow, or resources. Mars is at the last degree of Aquarius, so there's a sense of urgency for certain activities to be playing out. The moon is at the end of Leo, so there will be a mood change, but not until the following day. So for the rest of the day, the moon is in conjunct to Neptune and then opposite Mars. So I would say it could be a very active day, you know, not only because of all this Aries, but because the moon opposite Mars creates emotional need to be, you know, engaging in some activity in this critical urgency at the 29 degree. But something is also ready to end and change. And that's a part of Venus crossing Saturn. Something is at a turning point here around value, preferences, desires, relationships, money. And then the vibes really change after that. The moon is in conjunct to Neptune, so there's also perhaps distractions and things pulling us inward, or mostly distractions and energetically sensitive, or just things that are like pulling us to behind the scenes versus this more outward social dynamic of Leo versus Aquarius and Mars moon there. It can also get passionate, dramatic, you know, with moon opposite Mars. But luckily, the Sun is in a good sextile with Pluto, so the overall power dynamic should be in good balance for the most part. But it's still serious Venus activity going on for Thursday. And then by the time we wake up on Friday, there's a mood change with the Moon ingressing Virgo. There's also a finger of God aspect here right when the Moon comes into Virgo from the Sun and Pluto focused right to the Moon of the circumstances and the mood, which has shifted into a more practical earthly position, which is probably pretty good. We need some more earth here with all this going on. So with the Moon in Virgo for the next 2.5 days, it is waxing through here. It's about work, service. It's about making improvements, getting organized, purifying, cleaning up. And it comes right back to Mercury. Now Mercury is in charge of the circumstances with the Moon in Virgo. Comes back to this Aries position of starting things, what we need to do. And this will lead to a change of Mars as well by the end of the day, coming ingressing Pisces. And what motivates us will start to change. But for the first part of the day, Mars is still at this critical part of Aquarius, a sense of urgency to be doing something here. So again, if you're in a more work service type of mood, you're in the flow of the astrology, keep things clean. That's very important for the Virgo moon. Virgo moon is also about helping others, being of service to others. It's not so much about the self, which is why the moon is in conjunct the sun in Aries. Because the focus is on the self and independence and freedom and our individuality, where the mood is more connected to service for other people. So having to make adjustments between what we're focused on versus where the circumstances of the day are going through. And this is later in the day too. This is 3:30-ish in the afternoon on the West Coast. So it's already the evening on the East Coast on Friday here. So management, organization, improving things, work, service. It's just more of a practical, grounded, down-to-earth mood, but it's also more up in the head as well. A lot of thinking and processing and analyzing things. And then having to make adjustments to this more outward social dynamic where Pluto is. Also, this finger of God indicating something perhaps fateful in general is happening. Especially if you have a planet, the first couple degrees of Virgo, then this finger of God is pointing right towards that planet for you. So pay attention. If you have 0 to 3 degrees of Virgo, the moon goes across that with this finger of God, and there could be something fateful connected to that area of your life or that what that planet means in your birth chart. So pay attention to that on Friday afternoon, Friday evening, depending on where you live. All right, so then, yeah, it's mostly in conjunctions. So a lot of adjustments, some irritations, just this overall mood change, just trying to adapt to new vibes, new circumstances for Friday. And then we get to that last aspect of the day on Friday night, which is Mars changing signs, leaving Aquarius, ingressing Pisces. So now this puts a lot more emphasis on behind the scenes activity. That's where the action is going to come back to, you know, and it all depends on your birth chart as well. Wherever you have Pisces in your birth chart, that's where there's a new level of activity. That's going to be a strong area of activity, I would say, for the next couple months, because Mars is going to go all through there during the eclipses. Mars will be in Pisces. That area is where there's a connection to the eclipses, especially mid Pisces. You know, Mars is going to meet up with Saturn in mid-Pisces during the solar eclipse. But wherever you have Pisces, you know, that's where the action is. And with all this Aries, it comes right back to that Mars behind the scenes in Pisces. So now the motivation has changed. Something has changed. Something is starting to mellow out a little bit too with the Moon in Virgo opposite all the Pisces. But overall, Mars, our drive, our passion, how we take action. Now the action is influenced by our surroundings, by what we're connected to, the people in our life, the things that we watch, the things we hear are going to greatly influence how we proceed forward. You know, it's not as easy. It's not as easy to be like just really decisive in this position. It's more energetically sensitive. You know, it's a little more energetically, like kind of not as grounded, not as practical, not as motivated, not as fiery and passionate. It's kind of in a dream state, you know, when it comes to action. But on the other hand, Mars in Pisces can be the martyr. It can be, you know, taking action based on belief systems, spiritual motivation. So a lot of times with Mars in Pisces, it is good to get like inspiration through astrology, metaphysics, divination, connecting to your higher power of spirituality to help motivate you, to drive you, to know what to do. But on the other hand, with Venus and Mars in Pisces next to Saturn, sometimes there can be this need to escape. It's all too much. It's overwhelming. You know, you've lost the motivation perhaps to initiate a brave, you know, change in your life that you need to do. You're going to be pushed to do that as time goes on regardless. But in the beginning stages, there can also be a retreat vibe with this, you know, feeling too tired, too exhausted, or escaping into, you know, bad habits, alcohol, drugs, avoidance, you know, things like that. But I just feel because these are eclipses coming up, we're going to be forced. There's life-changing things that will force us to take the initiative, or life itself will change on us and we'll have no choice but to start something, do something, not necessarily right when Mars comes in here, but over this next month, you know, with the Libra eclipse and then the Aries eclipse. So try to, you know, just be careful of what you're being influenced by, basically, because what you're being influenced by could determine how you proceed forward in your life. So make sure you're around healthy influences. Make sure your environment is clean. You know, that goes a long way in feeling good and healthy with Pisces vibes. When you have Virgo opposite that, you need to organize, clean, manage, have a plan. You know, keeping your surroundings beautiful, nice, and pleasant can go a long way in feeling healthy and good to be taking appropriate action in your life. But also just make sure you're not surrounded by unhealthy influences that can hold you back. And it is a health kind of dynamic too. You know, Pisces deals with a lot of health, that health in regards to things that are hard to diagnose and hard to figure out. You know, and sometimes you have to question, is it kind of up in the mind? Is it psychological health conditions versus more practical, you know, physical conditions? But with the moon in Virgo, it's all about health in a lot of ways. Opposing all this, opposing Saturn, you know, there can be health situations that come in strong as well by the end of the week, into the weekend. I would say this whole time period already, just having these transits in Pisces, including Saturn, major health conditions need to be worked on for the next couple of years for people, especially the bad habits, bad patterns, psychological issues, things like that. So again, a new motivation of what inspires us to take action. So that is Friday. That's the last aspect. Then we get to the weekend, March 23. Make sure my video is still going here. The moon is halfway through Pisces as we get to March 23. And right off the bat, the moon is opposite Saturn and Venus. So it's also bringing something to a head in context to the serious relationship, serious financial dynamics playing out earlier in the week. Something's at a turning point now for that, because it's like the moon is opposite. It's like the culmination point. But it's also serious. Also, the moon is as far away as you can get to Venus, the pleasure, the, you know, the love. It could still be a little bit serious, but I feel like it's a turning point from this point on. Venus will start to separate from Saturn. Venus is now going to be sextile Jupiter in a couple days. It's almost there. It's building up. It's already considered a sextile, but the moon, you know, is going to start to trine Jupiter. So it's bringing this relationship and financial dynamic out in some way, perhaps on Saturday as well. But with the moon opposite Saturn, it still could be a little bit heavy, still feel a little bit restrictive and limited. There could be work, obligations, duty, commitments that are, you know, in the circumstances. But then it should all smooth out because the moon is trine Jupiter for Saturday morning, which is more optimistic, more supportive and cooperative with circumstances and the overall mood after the heaviness of the early morning hours. And then the moon is making inconjunctions, you know, which is a little bit irritating perhaps, and adjusting to things, adjusting to the north node of the future, relationship, individuality, things we want to start and do, the plans. It's still in a work, service, health context, organization, management, practicality, analyzing all through the weekend here. Jupiter is also in conjunct to that south node of relationships and money, making adjustments or just trying to find a better balance in something that we're dealing with overall. And then the moon is in conjunct to Chiron. So the moon in Virgo is not really mixing with Aries. Again, Aries is about the individuality, the self, freedom, you know, independence, starting things, being brave and courageous, jumping fast, head in first into things, going quickly. Whereas Virgo, it's more logical. It wants to do things right. It's the perfectionist sign, you know, and work and service for others, not just about the self. So having to make a lot of adjustments between those circumstances versus all this focus on the self and our what we want to do individually. And then the moon is trine Uranus and then in conjunct to Mercury. So the trine down to Uranus says we have the opportunity here to feel comfortable with changes, to do things differently, step outside of the box, make improvements by doing things a little differently than the past, which can be in any context in your life that you're working on things. So making improvements with money, resources, management, health, daily life, work, service, you know, there's an opportunity to be okay with change, basically, and not fighting against change. And then the in conjunction to Mercury, the mood is at odds with the mind, you know, so it's not the greatest time to get your point across, to be communicative, to write, to publish something, you know, it's kind of at odds with all that for a little bit there on Saturday all day, especially Saturday night with the moon in conjunct to Mercury. So that's the Saturday vibe. It's still in Virgo, but then we get to Sunday, March 24. We start the day off at the last degrees of Virgo there, but the mood was going to change. However, the moon is opposite Neptune, so it's like we have distractions. We're being pulled into behind the scenes, energetic sensitivity, retreat versus work and service, or just thinking more practically and logically versus intuition, kind of this opposition. It can be an opposition within a relationship dynamic on Sunday morning between someone being extra sensitive versus someone being more logical and practical about things. But it starts to change the mood, basically. It can also stir up the need to clean up from weather events or flooding or other situations connected to water events or storms on Sunday morning. But this is where things start to really change because we come into this eclipse vibe now from this point on, because Venus is also in conjunct to the south node with the finger of God aspect from Venus Jupiter to the south node point at 15 Libra. So if you have planets at 15 Libra, you're already going through major situations because that's where the eclipse is. That's where the south node is. But now there's something activated in a fateful way, perhaps, to your planet if you do have it at 15 Libra on Sunday morning, Sunday afternoon. Something is taking place with either money or relationship activity that's connected to this eclipse in a bigger way as well. And then we do see that Venus does make a sextile to Jupiter, that positive connection I talked about. After something serious is unfolding throughout the week, then there's a gain or a benefit from it, perhaps by next Sunday into next week. You know, especially in a financial context, Sunday into Monday. But the moon changes signs, ingresses Libra, and right as the moon comes into Libra, I would say it's the full moon vibes are on, the eclipse vibes are on. But now Venus is in charge of the circumstances and the relationships. That's what it's all about. There's this bigger emotional need to deal with relationships, work on relationships, smooth out relationships on Sunday night. And it comes back to this Venus exalted sextile Jupiter. It should be somewhat positive, but this is also eclipse season. It's also unpredictability, wild card vibes here. You never know with eclipses of what's going to happen because it exposes shadow. It exposes things in a way that brings consciousness expansion that changes perception for the long term, your feelings, your emotions, circumstances, you know. Keep in mind, it's also the full moon at the same time, the peak of emotional energy within the context of relationship. But you also have to realize that Venus is very strong here in Pisces, connecting to a positive planet, Jupiter. So I don't feel like it has to be negative. It just puts more emphasis on wanting to be fair, nice, balanced, objective, taking in other people's perspective, giving other people the time, you know, being more loving, more sweet, accommodating for the next 2.5 days. And again, it's something is coming to a head. Something has become full and ready to change in a way that's bigger than a normal full moon. You know, an eclipse, it has long-term effects on the future based on these changes, something culminating within the context of relationship and perhaps financial situations as well. So if you do want to buy something, perhaps this is the opportunity on Sunday or into Monday with Venus-Jupiter sextile. And it's great value. Venus is very strong. It's in the Taurus. Venus owns Taurus. It's a quite positive aspect in a lot of ways. But right as the moon comes into Libra, on Sunday, the moon is trine Pluto. So it's also the beginning of this transformation to relationships, circumstances. Now the moon is in this outward position of Libra. It's an air sign. It's intellectual. It's communicative, social. And there's a good connection to the Aquarius and the power dynamic. It's more fair and balanced in this position, the power between people. But the moon is also in conjunct to Mars, which is a little bit, you know, edgy and a little bit of some having to adapt and deal with something behind the scenes as well. That's not quite mixing with this more like compromising type of vibe. You know, there's still some energetic stuff going on here in the background with Mars. And then the activity and the mood are kind of on two different pages right when the moon comes in on Sunday. But that's the change, you know. There's a big change of mood here by Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening. And pretty much the eclipse. Because the eclipse is going to be, you know, the overnight hours of Sunday into Monday. So when you see that full moon on Sunday night, that's when it's at its like closest, the strongest, you know, the most powerful point. If you wait till Monday night when they say that the eclipse is going to be Monday night, you know, the full moon on Monday night, technically, but you can see that the full moon is exact at literally midnight, right past midnight. Exactly midnight. So technically it's March 25, the eclipse and the full moon, but it's really that Sunday night that it's at its strongest, closest point. And then the full moon vibes are all day on Monday as well. And yeah, you'll see the moon on Monday night too, but the eclipse is actually at midnight on the West Coast. So it's like 3 a.m., I guess, on the East Coast. So we do come into Monday with that eclipse. And so this is the big event, March March 25, the moon will be at 5 degrees of Libra. So check your chart. Do you have any planets at 5 degrees of Libra or within a degree or two of 5 degrees? If you do, this eclipse is major for you. Whatever that planet is in your birth chart is being eclipsed. There's a sense of something is ending with that, with the, how that planet functions, and it's changing into something new, you know. And again, this is a full moon. So it's like there's a culmination here. We had a solar eclipse 6 months ago in October in Libra. So now things have been unfolding for the last 6 months that have led to this culmination point of a major turning point within relationship dynamics. Is it negative? It doesn't feel like it's negative to me in general, because this eclipse is ruled by an exalted Venus sextile Jupiter and Uranus. There's something new available. Jupiter's moving into new territory. This eclipse is a turning point for that. So the positive side of it would be relationships ready to move forward into new territory in a positive way. There could be, you know, some relationships that have to end because it's a culmination. It's a turning point. If they're not willing to start something new with this Aries vibe, then they might have to end or change, or something about the dynamics within certain relationships of your life have to go through a change now that will have a long-term effect on the future. But on the other hand, any positive connections to relationships you have that are moving into new territory will also have a long-term effect on the future. This isn't just a normal full moon. This is going to have a connection for the next 18 and a half years of what's unfolding, in a sense, you know, within these relationship dynamics. It could also very well be about money and resources in some way, you know, that's also ready for a change, ready to move into new territory, ready for a bigger commitment in some way. And I would say if it's not a limitation or a restriction within a relationship that this eclipse is talking about for you, then it is about making a commitment that's building up all week with Venus Saturn, you know, connected to Jupiter Uranus. Venus is just in a good position here in Pisces, exalted, that doesn't want to be like, it's more self-sacrificing, you know, more willing to see the good in other people, not see the bad. You know, so I feel like it has more of a positive connection. But don't get me wrong, there's still going to be some relationships that will have to end, you know, all depending on your own birth chart and how it all plays out for you. So it can go either way. But ultimately, it's about something ending and starting in new ways. Something ready for a change. Something reaching this culmination point. And overall, with the South Node eclipse, it's about something that has to change, something that has to be let go of to do better relationship. And this is the beginning of this overall rebalancing, like I've been saying for a while, between Aries and Libra. You know, it's not about just going off on your own, being independent all your life, you know, and leaving all relationship behind. That doesn't seem healthy to me. What's healthy is not losing your sense of self within relationship. What's healthy is maintaining your individuality and having your own drive, having passions, having things that you're going after for yourself, for your own interests, and still being engaged in partnership and relationship with other people. So just doing relationship better. That's what it's all about, is creating long-term changes to how you do relationships in your life. And that can be on multiple levels. It can be romantically, family, business. It doesn't matter. Put it in context to what's most relevant in your life right now of how you need to change relationship dynamics for the better. And I do believe with Venus exalted ruling the eclipse, it can be for the better. But Venus is also preparing to sextile Uranus. So it requires stepping outside the box, be willing to do new things that you haven't done in the past. And also when it comes to money and resources within relationship dynamics and partnership dynamics, those things need to change as well, perhaps, to accommodate better relationship and partnership. So to me, I think it has a lot of positive potential for better relationships. But regardless, we're at a turning point. We're at peak emotional energy. Eclipses expose shadow. So we're also becoming more aware of relationship situations. We're becoming more aware of what's out of balance in our life as well, and what needs to be readjusted and changed to be in better balance. So we're becoming aware of the darker side, the shadow, what was hidden, you know, and something is being eclipsed out and ready for change in order for better dynamics to come in. Now, the eclipse is also in conjunct to Saturn. So there's a little bit of this realization that could be a little bit heavy about it at the same time, you know, or pressure, stress, commitments, duties, obligation to other people, you know, that we have to factor in and be willing to let go of something to accommodate commitments and responsibilities as well with others. The moon is also in conjunct to Jupiter as the day goes on, Monday. Having to rebalance, adjust money and resources with relationship, or just generally rebalancing something, being more objective about it, looking at it in a better intellectual way. And then, yeah, the moon is with the South Node as well for all day on Monday. So it's coming back to what needs to end, what needs to change, what we need to let go to accommodate something new and better for the future. So, folks, that's what I'm looking at when it comes to this eclipse and this week ahead. I think it is a very powerful, pivotal time of the year, especially when we get through April and Mercury's done with the retrograde. The whole second half of the year is going to be a whole different dynamic than where we are now until we get through the spring here. But I hope that's helpful. And again, if you want a personalized report, check the description. There's a link there. Get on my work list. We'll check out your year ahead. We'll look at the bigger picture of your life as well. And thanks for watching. I wish you the best. Take good care.